12th one is the same as what I have repeated in the previous problem. The same cost price and invoice price, both are given in the problem. Take 13th one now. Amir of Surat consigned goods to Praveen of Patna. The value of the goods is 50,000. The value of 50,000 invoiced at what? 20% above cost. So he has given you the value of the goods is 50,000 and is asking to add 20% above cost. To which case it is? This case is what? Add-on cost. So he is asking you, he has given you the cost price and is asking you to add 20% of loading. So loading is adding as 20% of 50,000. That is 10,000 is adding extra and sending the goods. So this is the invoice price. So he is sending the goods to his agent at 60,000. So whenever you add extra price and send the goods, what is the entry? Consignment to goods sent on consignment. You are adding extra and sending the goods. So whenever we add extra price, this has to be unloaded. What is the extra price you are adding here? 10,000. That has been unloaded by writing on the credit side. Why you are doing this? 60 minus 10, you got the cost price or not? Why you are bringing it to down to cost price? In order to get that profit. So what is the impact? So when you unload the goods, you are going to get what? You are unloading the goods to get the cut profit. So we have sent the goods and we have unloaded the goods. So whenever you send the goods at invoice price, the goods has to be unloaded by writing it on the credit side. Next, Amir is the consignor. Amir paid 800 for carriage and 600 for insurance. The total expense comes to 1400. So expenses met by consignor is 1400. The entry is what? Consignment accounted out of cash. You know about it. Next, Amir drew a bill for rupees 20,000 for 2 months. Whenever he gives a bill, you may receive the advance either in check or a bill. So we have got a bill, so change it to what? Buy bills receivable. We got a bill of 20,000 as what? Advance. The entry is bills receivable to consignee. Whenever we receive a bill, we write a bill receivable to consignee. Later, Amir received an account sales from Praveen stating the following. Total goods were sold for rupees 70,000 and the sales expenses is what? 1,000. The entire stock is sold for 70,000 and selling expenses is what? 1,000. What is the commission he has charging? 5% on sales. On 70,000, 5% comes to 3,500. So this is for sending the goods. Because the goods has been sent at invoice price, that has been unloaded by writing on the credit side. 2 cash is for expenses, 2 consignee is for expenses met by consignee, 2 consignee is for commission. Is there is any unsold stock in the problem or not? Yes, there is an unsold stock. How to value this unsold stock? So the total goods sold for rupees 70,000. Sorry, there is no unsold stock because the entire stock is sold. When there is no unsold stock, there will not be any consignment stock reserve because we did not value any unsold stock at invoice price. So no need to unload what? Unsold stock reserve. Now find out the profit. Which side is more? Credit side. 80,000. 80 minus 62,400. 65,400. 65,900. 4,100 is what? 2 P&L. And 2 consignment is for what? Sales. By consignment is for what? Expenses met by consigning. By consignment is for commission. By bank is for settlement. How can you find out the settlement amount? Close the consignee's account. Whatever balancing, he has to give us 70,000. After adjusting the advance and expense and commission, he has to still pay 70 minus 20, 50, 50 minus 4, 46, 45,500. So by consignment, we have sent the goods at what? Invoice price. Whenever you send the goods at invoice price, that has to be unloaded by writing on the debit side. To consignment, when balancing figure will be transferred to what? Trading or purchases. By consignment, because we have sent the goods at invoice price, that has been unloaded by writing on the debit side, and the balancing 60 minus 10, only the cost price should be transferred to what? Trading or purchase.